हेलो एवरीवन, इन लास्ट वीडियो वी स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स एंड वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट फिजिकल बिहेवियर ऑफ मेटल्स. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द केमिकल बिहेवियर ऑफ मेटल्स. मोस्ट मेटल्स अंडरगो सिमिलर काइंड्स ऑफ रिएक्शन. द विग्योर विद विच दे रिएक्ट इज नॉट द सेम. सम मेटल्स आर मोर रिएक्टिव देन अदर्स. मेटल्स रिएक्ट विद हाइड्रोजन विच इज़ अ नॉन मेटल आर अरेंज्ड इन ऑर्डर their activity in a series which is called the activity series. This activity series you will show in this picture. This series help us to understand the reactions of metals. Now action of air on metal. The oxygen present in air acts on metal to form their oxides. Like if we react with potassium and sodium placed high up in the series are so active that they react with fast with air forming their oxides. So potassium and sodium are stored under kerosene because sodium and potassium are very reactive and they react with oxygen. Magnesium, aluminium and iron react more slowly with air. When left exposed they get tarnishes. The meaning of tarnishes is they lose their shiny surface because a thin film of oxide forms over their surface. On being heated in air these metals react faster. Like if we take a piece of magnesium with ignited bonds in air with a dazzling white light, when magnesium is burned in an open gas jar, white solid particles of magnesium oxide are deposited on the inner wall of the jar and the reaction is twice of Mg plus O2 is equal to magnesium oxide MgO. This is white color. Iron rusts slowly in moist air. Rust is a hydrated oxide of iron and the formula of rust is Fe2O3 into XH2O. Number of H2O is varies because the water molecule is varies in every molecule. Metal further down the series retain their shiny for a longer time because they do not react with air so easily. They are less reactive. When strongly heated in air, copper forms a black oxide which is known as cupric oxide, but silver and gold do not. When the chemical reaction of the air is prolonged beyond tarnishing, the compound forms slowly eat away the metal. This is called corrosion. Rusting of iron is a common example of corrosion. Other metals like magnesium, aluminium, zinc and copper, they also get corroded by the prolonged action of air. Copper forms a green solid on its surface whereas the other form except iron form grayish white solids. Now the next topic is displacement of one metal by another. A more active metal displaces a less active metal from compounds of the latter in solution. Like if we talk about aluminium and iron, it displaces copper from a solution of copper sulfate and the reaction is this is copper sulfate and iron is replaced copper and form iron sulfate and copper is replaced. Now we see a activity. In this we dissolve some crystal of copper sulfate which is called as blue vitriol in water. Place an iron nail in the solution. In a while the portion of nail which is inside the solution become red because a layer of copper gets deposited over the surface of the nail. The color of the solution will slowly change from blue to green due to the formation of iron sulfate. And the reaction is Fe plus CuSO4 is equal to copper Cu plus FeSO4. We can repeat this activity using a piece of magnesium or aluminium instead of the nail. Copper will be deposited but the resulting solution will be colorless because magnesium sulfate and aluminium sulfate are colorless. Children, this is the diagram of this activity. You will see the deposition of copper sulfate. Now, displacement of hydrogen from water. Metals higher than hydrogen in the activity series displace hydrogen from water. These below hydrogen do not. Also the more active the metal, the more vigorously does it react with water. Thus, potassium and sodium react vigorously even with cold water, while magnesium reacts only with steam. A burning piece of magnesium continues to burn vigorously when brought in contact with steam. Look, children, this is sodium and it reacts with water. It gives sodium hydroxide and oxygen and hydrogen gases liberated. Same as if we take hot magnesium and react with steam, it forms magnesium oxide and hydrogen gas. This is again a activity. In this, we cut a small piece of sodium and remove the kerosene by pressing the piece between the folds of filter paper. Draw the piece of metal into a trough of water. It melts to form a silvery white globule which darts about the surface of the water with a hissing sound. We will observe a yellow flame over the globule and hear intermittent pops because the heat evolved in the reaction melts the metal and hydrogen produced catches fire. After the reaction, the water of the trough will turn a red litmus paper blue because of sodium hydroxide form. Sodium hydroxide is an alkali and show the properties of a base. Now, the displacement of hydrogen from acid. Metals above hydrogen in this activity series displace hydrogen from dilute hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, but those below hydrogen do not. Also, the reactivity of the metal decreases down the series. In this, the reaction is sodium is react with hydrochloric acid. It gives sodium chloride. It is a colorless and hydrogen gas is liberated. And in the case of sulfuric acid, it reacts with magnesium and gives colorless magnesium sulfate and hydrogen gas. And if we take sulfuric acid with iron, then it gives iron sulfate, which is in green color, and hydrogen gas is again liberated. Will copper or silver liberate hydrogen from dilute acid? No, because they are less active than hydrogen. Children, last activity is last reaction with bases. Only some metals like aluminium and zinc dissolve in alkalis like sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide, forming salts and liberating hydrogen. Children, remember, reactions do not occur with sodium, with ammonium hydroxide is also an alkali. Aluminium plus potassium hydroxide, it gives potassium aluminate plus hydrogen. Same as if zinc is react with sodium hydroxide, it gives sodium zincate and hydrogen. Zinc is a metal and sodium hydroxide is a base. And in this reaction, aluminium is a metal and it reacts with base potassium hydroxide. It gives potassium aluminate and hydrogen. Okay, children, now we will discuss the questions regarding this video. Only one question for this video is from C part. How would you use the activity series while studying the displacement of hydrogen from acids by metal? The answer of this question is on page number 61. Metals above hydrogen in the activity series displace hydrogen from dilute hydrochloric and sulfuric acid, but those below hydrogen do not. Then come here and write this equation, twice of Na plus twice of HCl, it gives to twice of NaCl plus H2. Means sodium is react with hydrochloric acid dilute, it gives sodium chloride which is colorless and hydrogen gas is formed. Okay children, do this question in your notebook and draw the diagram of activity series in your notebook. Goodbye everyone.